I am Batman. I mean, Average Sniper.
What's up, everybody? Average Sniper here, bringing you another PUBG video. And today I want to talk about the recent problems that PUBG has had on Xbox and why they're experiencing these problems. Now, I don't work for PUBG, Bluehole, obviously, I'm just a YouTuber, but I think there's some people out there that are pretty pissed off about the experience they've been having. So before I get started, let me just say, and this isn't a video where I'm just going to bitch about PUBG because I don't like it. I really love PUBG. I have over 2,000 hours in PUBG between PC, Xbox, and mobile. I just love this game. I just want to know why it can't be, you know, a little more optimized so we can have a better experience. So, this is to open a discussion. I want you guys to blast that comment section with your opinions, whether they're good or bad or in between. I don't care. I just want to see that comment section get lit up because I want to see the experiences that other people are having with this game and what they think about it. So this gameplay, just so you know, is from PUBG Mobile. There is a new mobile emulator made by the official makers of PUBG Mobile that only pairs you up against other people using the emulator. It's very cool. You can check out the video description if you want to download it for free and play it on your PC. So guys, PUBG came out in March of 2017, and I was one of the first people to start playing it, along with all the other people that had pre-ordered it or had early access. Now, it was normal for the game to have a lot of bugs back then, and at sometimes it was unplayable, but eventually it got better and it got more optimized, and it actually runs really well now on PC, which is a little disappointing for me because I have bad ping to their servers. I want to play on PC more, but I can't stand playing with bad ping. But having said that, even though it works better on PC now, it still doesn't work as good as it could. There are a lot of other games out there that are even more graphically demanding than PUBG that can run much better frame rates. And it depends on the hardware you have, but you know, I have good hardware in my computer and I can run other games that are more graphically intense with a much higher frame rate. Now let's skip over to Xbox. The Xbox version of PUBG came out in December of 2017. And right before it came out, I went out and bought myself an Xbox One X, and I attached an external SSD to it. Now, why did I do this just to play a game? Well, first off, you know, obviously I make YouTube videos about games, so I do make a little money off my channel, so I like to have the latest stuff. But the main reason is because I knew how bad PUBG was on PC and how much struggle they had to optimize it, and I was doubting that PUBG could even run on an Xbox, much less an Xbox One OG edition. I was like, man, because I had the OG Xbox One. I got it in like the end of 2013, early 2014. It was pretty old. I've had it forever. It feels like forever. But I went ahead and gave that to my brother, and I got an Xbox One X with an external SSD. And the game ran good for me. It ran when it came out. I was surprised that it could actually run on Xbox, but I wasn't surprised by the low frame rates. I mean, when this game first came out, we were lucky to get 20 frames per second. The gunfights were terrible. The input lag was terrible. Don't get me wrong. They've definitely done a lot of improvements to the game. Improvements that should have been there in the first place, but nevertheless, improvements. Now, I feel really bad for everybody that spent money on this game with the Xbox One. Even though it was only $30, it's still money out of your pocket. I don't know how much you make. Maybe you're rich, maybe you're poor, maybe you're somewhere in between. But the point is, you paid for the game. And just because they slap a title on it that says early access doesn't necessarily, I don't think it means a game company should be allowed to release the product that's so unfinished. And it still is, guys, it still is. Especially after this last patch, we have a lot of issues. The game crashes. Since day one, have the game crashes really gotten any better? I actually feel like they might be getting worse because all my friends on the OG Xbox crashed all the time from when the game first came out. It was expected. I occasionally crashed on my Xbox One X, but I wouldn't crash at the same time as them. They would crash most of the time while moving at high speed in a vehicle, and I would crash most of the time randomly pulling up my inventory screen. The crashes never did get better for me. Every day that I played, I crashed. If I didn't crash on a day that I played, I thought, my God, that's insane. Totally insane. So I really, really feel bad for the people that went out there and spent several hundred dollars on an Xbox One X and maybe even an SSD. If you did that to play this game, you are dedicated, and I feel that you should be getting more. The reason I'm making this video is because, you know, I recently started playing PUBG Mobile on that emulator they released just to try it out. And I was so surprised at how well PUBG Mobile was running compared to the Xbox version. And I thought to myself, now, why is this, okay? Well, first, understand that there's a different company that is responsible for developing, maintaining, and patching PUBG Mobile. And it is a Chinese company called Tencent. If you're into gaming, you probably know who they are. They are huge over there, one of the biggest gaming companies in the world, actually. And it just goes to show you that PUBG actually can be optimized if you have the right people working on it. Now, of course, the graphics are really dumbed down in the mobile version to make it run smoother, but there's a lot of other things that run good, too. I mean, it doesn't crash. Get this. I installed PUBG Mobile on a 10-year-old laptop, and it ran just fine. It ran at 45 frames per second, which is way better than my Xbox One X has ever run. And we're talking about a 10-year-old laptop, barely worth $100 anymore, you know? And an Xbox One X is going to cost you, what, $500 plus maybe $150 for an SSD? So we're already talking like $650 plus the cost of the game, $680. I mean, we're up around $700 now just to get a console that can run PUBG, and it's still going to crash on you. Okay, guys, I'm not bitching. I'm just saying, this is crazy. I've never played a game like this before that you could spend so much money on, and it wasn't optimized as well as it could be. I mean, I don't know why they're not optimizing it. That's what I want to see in the comments. I want to see people's opinions about why it's not getting better on Xbox One. Of course, it is getting better in the sense that they're fixing little things and making the game run like maybe it should have run on day one, but I don't really consider that progress. What would be progress is if we didn't see any more crashes, if we could get 60 frames per second like the other games. I mean, 60 frames per second is a good expectation for an Xbox One X. Maybe somewhere between 35 and 45 frames per second on the OG Xbox. Can you imagine how much improvement that would be for people? They would love this game so much more. And then on the mobile version, you have all these options. Like, you can change the color schemes and make it more colorful. You can make it more dull. You can make it look more realistic. It blew my mind. I'm like, dude, the Xbox version doesn't even have as many options as the mobile version, and you can run this off a tablet. Off a tablet. Don't tell me a tablet is supposed to be more powerful than the $500 you just spent on an Xbox One X. I know some tablets are expensive, but you don't have to have a super awesome tablet to run this game. I ran it on a 10-year-old laptop. It was crazy. And we're talking about PUBG Mobile versus, you know, PUBG Xbox right now. So my mind is blown right now. Why won't they? I mean, why did it come to Xbox in the first place? Probably because Fortnite was threatening it. So they rushed it to Xbox. I get that. You know, they wanted, Fortnite was pulling over so many people to the console. They needed to get something on console, but at the expense of everybody who spent money on it. Why not make it free to play and put it in open beta until all the bugs are fixed? In my personal opinion, and I don't know if this is true. This is just my opinion. I think it was more of a business move, you know, a money-making move, than it was a move for the consumer, which is me and you and everybody that's going to spend money on it. I mean, I think if this were my company and I really wanted the game to do well and to last over time, I would have put it out for free, like Fortnite. Put a whole bunch of microtransactions in for not pay to win, but just like clothing and stuff like that to get some cash revenue. But they had to make it $30 to buy a game that still doesn't even work, like 6 months later. I mean, come on. it's crazy. There's going to be a lot of people that defend the game, and, you know, and sometimes I'm even one of them. But it gets to a point where you have to stop and say, wait, I love this game, but why am I defending it so much, you know, when another company can take it over, make a mobile version that actually looks half decent and runs twice as good, but you can't play it on your Xbox One X with your SSD that you just spent all this money on. I myself, I'm not personally hurt by this because I do make money making videos on this. I don't get paid by PUBG or any company except just the revenue I make on ads on my YouTube videos. That's it. So I feel like, you know, it's not that big a deal for me because the money I put into it is money I would have put into it anyway just to make videos about it. But for the average person who doesn't make money off of YouTube videos to go out and buy this and be so disappointed with the performance, I feel you. and I want to hear what you have to say in the comments. And let's hope that the PUBG devs catch on, and maybe they outsource to another company to help them, or maybe they just get on the ball and fix it. Can they fix it, or can they not fix it? I'm just tired of seeing all these patches that seemingly do nothing or make the game worse. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave me a like, leave me a comment. I can't wait to read them. Later, everybody.